Matthew Van Dyke. We are continuing the saga of his time in Libya from when he was captured, when he was taken to an interrogation room in Sirte, and then subsequently moved to solitary confinement in Tripoli. Talk about that sequence.
I was taken to Tripoli and put in a prison called Maktab al-Nasr. It was a cell about 4 foot by 7 foot, very dark, small skylight in the ceiling. I was never told what I was accused of, if I would ever be released. The guards did not know who I was. It was as if I did not exist. I didn't see any other prisoners. Late at night, the first few nights, I was hearing what I thought was a violent interrogation or maybe torture. So I trimmed my fingernails, my toenails down real low with a broken piece of plastic spoon in case they pulled out my fingernails, like in the movie Syriana.
Amazing.
Torture. And I prepared myself for the interrogation, trying to rehearse what possible excuse I could have for carrying weapons and video and things like this to try to talk my way out of it. But I knew there was nothing I could really say. I thought I'd be there 20 or 30 years, maybe executed. The other prisoners had written a lot of things in Arabic on the walls, and I know some Arabic, but I couldn't really understand it. Then they made notch marks each day that they were in prison, some of them. So they had 30 or 40, and soon mine were up to 85.
What was your temperament? Was it fear? was it panic? How stressful? This had to be incredibly stressful.
It was. I was really afraid. I knew that my life was over, as far as I knew. I was not going to get out of prison. I would not see my family again. Like, my life was completely finished, and nothing to do but sit and reflect on that. They didn't give me anything to read, nothing to do except sit and stare at the wall and think about it for 3 months almost.
No interaction with other prisoners?
No. I didn't even know that there were. Occasionally I would hear somebody banging, kicking a door or something that I figured was another prisoner somewhere else in the prison. But no, I didn't see any other prisoners. A little bit interaction with the guards, but not much. My Arabic's pretty good, but I also acted like I knew less Arabic than I did, because I wanted the guards to feel free to talk to each other and to keep their TV loud enough so that I could try to learn information without them realizing that I knew any Arabic.
What about sanitary conditions? What about food? About your health?
It was filthy. The food was okay, but they let me out to use a squat toilet 3 times a day. The rest of the time, they wanted me to urinate in bottles. After about a month, they gave me, I think on day 30, they gave me a bucket with water to wash my clothes and some soap to wash my clothes and myself. The toilet had these big black bugs that would live inside the squat toilet and crawl out at night, and they'd crawl into my cell and up on the walls. It was absolutely horrible.
An incredible story.